If you are in the earliest stages of pregnancy, you may hear your doctor refer to a pregnancy of unknown location. What is that? What does it mean for your current pregnancy? What does it mean for future pregnancies? Stay tuned and I will explain. Here is what happens when a normal pregnancy occurs naturally. An egg is released from the ovary. This is known as ovulation. A couple has intercourse and sperm are released into the vagina, which travel up into the uterus and eventually into the fallopian tubes. The egg is fertilized in the fallopian tube and the resulting embryo starts dividing and is moved by the fallopian tubes down into the uterus where it implants. Doctors would call this an intrauterine pregnancy because the embryo implanted in the uterus. If all goes well, 38 weeks later, the fetus is delivered. This is what occurs if everything happens like it should. Of course, things don't always go as they should. Therefore, doctors, especially fertility specialists like me, will do a lot of monitoring in the early portion of pregnancy to try to determine the health and location of a pregnancy. A fertilized egg cannot be detected until it is implanted. Once implantation has occurred, the hormone HCG, which is produced by some of the cells of the developing embryo, will be absorbed into the mother's blood. From there, it can be detected by doing a blood test. A little while later, after the levels get higher, the HCG can be detected in the urine through a home pregnancy test. A positive pregnancy test, either a blood or a urine test, does not tell you where the embryo implanted. It could have implanted in the uterus, or it might have implanted in the fallopian tube, or rarely, it could implant somewhere else in a woman's abdomen. Anytime an embryo implants outside of the uterus, it is called an ectopic pregnancy. If the only evidence for a pregnancy is a blood or a urine test, then this is referred to as a biochemical pregnancy, or more commonly now, a pregnancy of unknown location. If the pregnancy continues until it is able to be seen on ultrasound, then it is referred to as a clinical pregnancy. The earliest sign of a pregnancy on ultrasound is a small area of fluid known as a gestational sac. It is only after seeing a gestational sac that the location of a pregnancy can be known for sure. Okay, now that we know what a pregnancy of unknown location is, what does it mean if you are currently pregnant? There are three possible outcomes for a pregnancy of unknown location. It could be a pregnancy that is going to miscarry, it could be an ectopic pregnancy, or it could be a viable pregnancy in its very earliest stages. A study that was just presented here at the annual meeting of the American Society for Reproductive Medicine followed people with bleeding, cramping, and were subsequently found to have a pregnancy of unknown location. Ultimately, 13% of them turned out to have an ectopic pregnancy. Usually, only 1 to 2% of pregnancies turn out to be ectopic. About two-thirds of them went on to miscarry, which is about double what would be expected. What about future pregnancies? People who have had an ectopic pregnancy are much more likely to have another ectopic pregnancy. A small percentage of people have recurrent early miscarriages, so knowing the location of a pregnancy has a lot of importance for future pregnancies. Unfortunately, sometimes we will never learn the location of a pregnancy. It may remain unknown. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.